One thing that's really nice about the MatSE department is that you can be active in the undergraduate research. Since I also teach glass, it's also good to be active there as well and be able to focus on my studies too. Carlo Pantano has helped me with my academic career by just being really supportive. Hopefully we're going to be doing some research. John Mara and I have decided to do something with ancient glasses, so we're going to find like a chemical formula of one of the glasses and then we're going to try to remake it and then test the physical properties of it. The cool thing about that is I can go in the lab and make this glass. When you first start making anything, you start with a bubble, so you have like the pipe and you blow a bubble into it, and then you gather over that. And then you work towards inflating the bubble to a certain size, making sure that your bottom doesn't get too thin, because if your bottom gets thin, when you break it off, your bottom breaks off. Being able to go in class and understanding all these like theories and everything, it's so much easier because you see what's happening and that gives you a more concrete connection. So it's nice to be able to learn it and then go in the shop and be like, oh wow, this is doing this because of this, and you can actually see it. And it gives you a better understanding of what's going on. My interest in glass led me to pursuing a degree in MatSE because I wanted to be able to figure out how to develop my own color and be able to work with the material and maybe even incorporate metal into it somehow. The MatSE department has helped me pursue my goals by just being supportive. I mean, even though glass blowing is an art, it's still a science, and they have been more than willing to help me find funding when I didn't have it and help to support the glass shop. You have like a vase and you have your bottom done, you're gonna start working on the top or the cup. If you're gonna make a wavy bowl, you're gonna have a big bottom, and then you're gonna start opening that up. And once it gets to a certain degree of opening, then you spin it really fast in the glory hole, and then centrifugal forces open that up, and then you hang it upside down, and then the bowl automatically just creates like a sine curve wave. We have to knock it off and put it in a annealer, and it sits at 900 to 1000 degrees, and you put your piece in it, and it brings it down at a really slow temperature, a really long time. The whole art itself is just inspiring, because there's a lot that goes into it, and I like to work hard for something, and glass is hard because you're standing in front of a 2,000 degree glory hole, sweating to death, holding heavy things and trying not to get burned, and it's hard, it's not easy, and a lot of people can't take the heat, and it's rewarding in the end.